Good morning. Welcome to my thought for the day. I woke this morning just thinking about how serving God, serving Jesus, transforms even the most ordinary of things. That Jesus is able to take something very insignificant and change it into something incredibly profound. And it may be that you think that the things that you do for Jesus or the things you have to offer him are very insignificant, are very ordinary. But the thing that I was thinking about this morning was when Jesus turned the water into wine at that wedding feast. I don't want to get caught up in any of the detail of the story, but just there was a need. And Jesus took what was already available, and that was the jars that were there, and got them filled with something very ordinary, with plain old water. Now water, we deal with water every day in lots of aspects of our lives. And taking this water, Jesus changed the ordinary in not just to the special, but the extraordinary. Because it was said that this was the best wine. This was better than any of the other wine that had been served at that wedding feast. It was the best. And I was just thinking that it was just water until it was given to Jesus. And what you have may be something very, very small, very insignificant, maybe only the ability to visit somebody or to ring them up or to have lunch with them or to invite them in for a coffee. You may have something very small to offer, very insignificant. You remember in Matthew 25 when Jesus talked about separating the sheep from the goats, and it was all about whether they had ministered to the physical needs of the people in their world, visiting the prisoners or the sick, clothing those who hadn't got clothes, feeding those who hadn't got food. And Jesus said, if you've done it this to the least of my disciples, if you've done it to the least of them, you've done it to me. Jesus is able to take the very smallest things that we have to offer. We may think of them as very insignificant. It's just something we felt we should do. But God transforms it into something really, really significant. And he's in the business of doing that with everything, really. Everything on its own is okay, and sometimes it can be very special. But when committed to Jesus, it becomes extraordinary and not insignificant at all. When Paul talks about the wood, hay, stubble, and the assessment of things for eternity, of the things that we've done for other people. You know, we don't know what will be turned into those very special treasures that we lay up for ourselves in heaven. You know, so we should be looking for opportunities to serve the Lord in the simplest of ways. And just like Jesus took that water and transformed it, because it was he, because he'd been involved, he'd been brought into the situation, and this is the key thing, is he has promised he will never leave us nor forsake us. He's promised he will be with us. He's promised it. It's promised that he would be Emmanuel, God with us. And as we commit our day to God, and as we say, Lord, what are you going to get up to today? What can I do? What can I join in with? Or what can I do for you today? As you commit the time, perhaps the only thing you have to commit to Jesus is time. Perhaps you think you're not very good at anything else. You can just give him time and a pair of hands and a pair of lips and a willingness to talk about him. He will take those gifts and transform them into something really special. then you may never know, this side of eternity, how important the thing that you do is in the life of somebody else. Our faith is not just about wrapping ourselves up warm and keeping ourselves well in the spirit. It's about spreading the good news that Jesus came into the world to save sinners, and that he can save the worst of sinners and transform them into something they never thought they ever could be. It's all about change, all about transformation. And as you think about it today, I hope that the Lord will expand this thought in your mind of perhaps the things that you have thought were not even worth doing because they're just so ordinary. But Jesus has transformed our ordinary into eternal, and he can transform anything into silver and gold for the kingdom as you invite him in and as you share your life with him and follow him. Have a great day today. God bless you. I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye-bye.